Prior to the opening of the NATO's office, residents have been travelling to Enana and Kurunkuru for such services. This is now something of the past as Roads Authority has brought services at their doorsteps. The project costed government $225,000 and the aim is to have fully fledged NATO's facilities countrywide. Works and Transport Deputy Minister Vaikone Kundi warned the inhabitants against acquiring licenses in dubious ways.
Please do not fall prey to people with dubious agendas. All NATO services are done over the counter and at official NATO senders. But again, some of those people come to the senders behaving exactly wearing nice suits, nice clothes. Some can even have make their own clothes look like NATO's officials. Please be vigilant. So therefore, please ensure that you get official documents and receipts after concluding your transactions with NATO's. I would also like to warn those people with dubious agendas who are carrying out fraudulent activities that if you are caught, you will face the full wrath of the law. And that's why I'm happy the law enforcement colleagues are present here.
Roads Authority has signed an agreement with Okongo Village Council to manage the NATO's office on their behalf. Okongo Village Council vehicle license mark was also introduced to the public. Tanatenia Imbodi, NBC News, Okongo.